shaft horsepower helping propel that aircraft up into the air. So positioning now to the south. This aircraft, or I should say C-130s, have been used on every continent in the world by the station. All the Army guys are ready to go. We're waiting 15 seconds out. The navigator's looking outside the window. He sees his mark, and it's a green light. And when the green light goes, there's no stopping. Those paratroopers are moving. They're going out the back. If they do stop, they're going to get pushed out. Now, folks, Paul Linehan, the low master, should be in the corridor. If he's back, as you see, there'll be an air deflector open. He'll be standing there, hopefully giving you a wave. So let's wave back. He's well, I believe. One of the important things now, of course, is we change aircraft configuration, the co-pilot running checklist, making sure the paratroopers are brought in, the air deflectors open to allow that to stop.
Trojan, Trojan, missile sweep bearing 180, little quarter block. Break right, no change. Break right.
Set in as cap, and Andrews is now demonstrating one of those tight turns, 60 degrees angle back. That is a flight limit in peacetime. The aircraft can go higher than that if it has to in manoeuvring, but it's a big aircraft. It can weigh nearly 175,000 pounds fully loaded, so care has to be taken to make sure that while we are manoeuvring and avoiding things, that we're not damaging the aircraft at the same time. So Andrew will bring it round. You'll get a nice photo opportunity, folks, as it's planned for. A reversal to south for one more maneuver.